Your love of classical music is a unique element of your writings. You speak about listening to Bach, Beethoven, Tchaikovsky, Mendelssohn, Stravinsky as religious experiences. But what's even more powerful, you talk about them as if they're almost like rabbis and spiritual guides that help you encounter Hashem, God, and listen to the inner music of Halacha. As a musician myself, I find this theme in your writings very powerful. Can you talk a bit about what age and when you first fell in love with classical music? And also, what stage of your religious journey did you start realizing that these classical musicians were not just classical musicians, they were religious role models for you and could almost create a religious experience for you?
Yes. My parents, who were completely secular, were very particular about giving me and my brother and me, a classical education. We went to the gymnasium, as it's called, and we had an excellent education, and part of that was music. My father wanted us to play music. I'm speaking about my brother and me. My brother is 70 and I'm 73. And he bought a, how do you call this in England? In English, a big piano, a grand piano. We had a big house. And we got a Jewish teacher who looked like the brother of Ben Gurion, wild, white hair, who very Jewish, had no kesher whatsoever with Yahadut. And he taught us to play music, or better, play the piano. My brother later on went more in jazz and also sings, had his own band for quite a few years. I never had. And I do remember, by the way, just nice to know, is that when my father brought this piano into our home, he was very proud about it, showed this to this Ben Gurion, and Ben Gurion looked to it, played on it, and said to my father, "Throw it into the Bach, it is not worth a penny." I still remember these words because the sound was not good enough. He was an excellent teacher, and he put a lot of love in me for playing piano and altogether to listen to music, which since that day I have been doing, except perhaps in the days that I was in yeshiva, there was not much time. Later, when I developed religiously, this was at the time, it's okay. This was at the time when I was not at all religious. It was just music, which I loved. I didn't know what it did to me. It did something, but I would not have been able to put it under any kind of title or give it any name. But many, many years later, when I got involved into religion, and especially in halacha, and I was struggling with halacha, this law and this legality. How do you make a kesher with your neshama? The halacha is one thing, the neshama is something else, I thought. And suddenly I realized it is music which is the kesher. That's the string between them, the shalshalet between them. And then I threw myself into music. I didn't play piano anymore because when we came on Aliyah, I didn't have a music instrument anymore, which I still regret till this very day. Somewhere in the back of my mind, I would like to go back there, but I don't know if that ever will happen. But since that day, music indeed became a religious experience for me. And then I realized that I first found this with Stravinsky, who is a very strange composer. I realized, wait a moment, there is the answer to my halachic problem. And that is, what has halacha to do with my neshama? And this has developed, probably subconsciously, over the years, and became stronger and stronger, to the point that I am now totally taken in by music. Sometimes I believe that whether it is Bach or Mozart or Paganini, I'm even more in love with them with the halakha, which I hope is not true, but I'm suspecting myself. But definitely for me, they are sent by God to teach us what real religiosity and a real religious experience is all about. And this has become an unbelievable blessing in my life. I often live under a lot of lagods and tension, and the moment I put on music, it disappears. So what I'm doing now is, literally, in the moment that I get into my office, I put first on music before I look to my emails, 150 a day about, and then the day goes by much easier because of this music. I also listen to the Beatles, I listen to Stravinsky, I listen to, what is his name, Gershon, the Jewish modern, I forgot his name now, Gershwin, what is his name, Gershwin, yeah. And I listen to jazz, I listen to old jazz, to modern jazz. It all speaks to me. But in general, the more classical music from the great composers like Mozart and Beethoven speak the most to me. I last, when was it, 2 days ago, I watched a movie about one particular Beethoven symphony, how he put it together and how it was played and what went wrong and the people criticizing him. And I thought to myself something like, well, the critique which they have on Beethoven, Lahavdil, and I mean in favor of Beethoven, that's the same critique I get when I write my stuff. It may sound strange, perhaps a little arrogant, but it is so typical. People are in their own little boxes, and then suddenly somebody walks in who throws everything over, like Beethoven clearly did, and then people get terribly upset about it, and then 100 years later it is considered to be the greatest kind of music.